Hey, it's Vaughn, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, ladies and gentlemen, the completionist run, the 100% run. We are going to be doing everything. People are still incredulous, but you'll see. You'll see. I've done it once before. I can do it again. Anyways, in the last episode, we finished the tutorial tunnel, or the tunnel, as I like to call it, and that's probably the last time I'm going to reference it in this entire LP, because we are done. Let's take a look at our quest. We have Unbound. I've been captured by the Empire and sentenced to death alongside the Stormcloak rebels. We were taken to Helgen, but before I could be executed, a dragon appeared and attacked the town. How convenient, right? I need to find some way to escape, and I don't know about you guys, but I think if we go through this thing right here, it says we can go to Skyrim. Hey, that's the name of this game that we're Let's Playing. I wonder what awaits us outside. Let's see how fast the loading times are. Pretty damn fast.
Wait. Looks like he's gone for good this time. But I don't think we should stick around to see if he comes back. The closest town from here is Riverwood. My uncle's the blacksmith there. I'm sure he'd help you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
No, you wouldn't. I did like 90% of the DPS. We should be able to talk to Hadvar.
Closest town from here is Riverwood. My uncle's the blacksmith there.
I know. You already said that, Hadvar.
It's probably best if we split up.
Hadvar, you already said this. Hadvar, I need to...
Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your
help. Need to stop you there. Hadvar, please. Oh, that's weird. I thought he had some dialogue options. I guess not. I keep pressing the left stick to sprint because, I recently did a stream of The Elder Scrolls Online, and the left stick is the sprint button. But no, in Skyrim, it's the LB button.
Solitude and join up with the Imperial Legion. You could really use someone like you.
Okay, now I think...
The rebels have themselves a dragon. General Tullius is the only one who can stop them.
Now I think we should be able to talk to Hadvar.
I hope that dragon is still flying around.
So we can talk about the Imperial Legion. And all of this other stuff. But of course, most of us already have been through those dialogue options. So we're going to keep this Let's Play moving because I want to catch up to the original Adranok. Well, this is the original Adranok, but you know what I mean. As soon as possible. So, but I don't want my commentary to fall by the wayside either. We're going to go pretty much over everything that we went over, like I said, the last time we did this for those three episodes. So here are the Guardian Stones. And if you don't know how this works, basically we have the Thief Stone, the Mage Stone, and the Warrior Stone, and you want to pick the one that, is acclimated to what you're going to be doing. Of course, we're a mage, so we're going to go ahead and go with the Mage Stone. Those under the sign of the mage will learn all magic skills 20% faster. You may only have one sign blessing at a time. Well, that's going to help us a lot better than the Thief Stone or the Warrior Stone, so let's go with that. And boom, just like that, all of our skills in regards to magic increase 20% faster. I kind of have like a love-hate relationship with those because it just feels like it's so easy. You start the game and you instantly get a 20% increase. It's like, what's the point? You don't even have to work for it at all. So just like the last time around, we are going to be exploring Ember Shard Mine. And one of the things that I'm going to be doing in this Let's Play is every time we find a new skill, Adranok is going to want to test it out. So in the last episode, we found Sparks. Flames does 8 points of damage per second, targets on fire take extra damage, Sparks does 8 points per second too, but it also deals damage to Magicka. So Flames does more because targets on fire take more, whereas Sparks damages Magicka. So we want to be sticking with Flames, but because Sparks is a new spell, we're going to kill this bandit. I almost said burn, but that wouldn't make much sense, would it? What does Emperor Palpatine say when he does this to people? I'm not really sure. I'm not that big of a Star Wars fan, but anyways... the first bandit is dead, so now we know what Sparks does. We're going to go ahead and switch back to Flames, though, since they do more damage. They just do, and that makes sense, doesn't it, to stick with the Flames. So nice playing games on PC because I rarely ever have to edit the loading screens out since the loading is so incredibly fast. But this is Ember Shard Mine, and like I said the last time around, and I promise you guys, you won't have to hear me say that, like I said the last time around, much longer. But, nevertheless, like I said the last time around, this is sort of just the first dungeon they give you just to show you that you can explore, etc.
This again? I told you, we have someone standing guard out there.
Who's dead?
Don't forget the rock trap we rigged up.
Which is disarmed.
Stop your worrying and get some rest. Your shift is coming up and I don't want you dozing off again like last time.
I wonder if we can hit them from here. Ooh, I was gonna wait till... we were found out. Looks like that's going to be the case now. I wonder if the flames in our hand decreases our sneak potency at all. Probably not. I don't think the game is that in-depth. But that would be kind of cool because we do have light in our hands. Alright, so let's loot these guys. They don't really have much. Yeah, I gotta get out of that sneak mindset because we're playing a mage. Not an assassin character like I usually do. Last time we explored this water and we found out there was nothing. So look at that, we're already streamlining this experience. We already know there's nothing down there. But we also know there is something down here. There's a coin purse, some more imp stool. Sorry, fly, what, a manchia or something like that? And also the tattered journal. And I believe we read this last time, so let's read it this time. They've had me working down here for days now. It's not the time that's getting to me, though. It's these tunnels. I've told them countless times now to add extra supports to the weak sections of the tunnel. If only we had more of those wooden beams that we reinforced with bronze bottoms. Honestly, if I hear the earth shift one more time above my head, I'll be so stressed I may stop drinking for good. I mean, what's a Nord without his mead? And obviously things didn't turn out well for him. So, let's explore more of Ember Shard Mine. We'll go into sneak when it is necessary and appropriate, like right now. Hey, look, a lever. Let's pull it.
I thought we had a guard posted outside. We did. Huh?
Aw, you guys ruin it. I want to hear all your dialogue, but you guys just have to see me over here. I'm being sneaky. Come on now. Oh, that's weird. Okay, showing me the health bar of this guy. I was like, that guy's dead. Why do I still see a health bar? So pretty easy so far. And this is, again, on adept difficulty. Every time I do a Let's Play, I put it on normal difficulty, and there's always, like, two people that comment, like, why are you playing on easy? Yeah, not playing on easy. And if you don't believe me... Hey, look at that. It's on adept. So, yeah, not novice. But, you know, there is the camp that says that, magic is too OP, but whatever. We're doing what I want to do. That's the best way to do a Let's Play. And also, we're going to throw that guy into the water there because that's what I want to do as well. Yeah. If people just mold the Let's Play after what everybody tells them to do, it's not organic. It's not... It's just not real, you know? So anyways, we've got a spell tome clairvoyance, and I believe I hear some footsteps. Maybe not. Okay, so new spell. You guys know what that means. First, we need to activate it. Boom. And let's see what this spell does. I think we all know, or most of us anyways. Shows the path to the current goal. Okay, let's use that, shall we? Did that even work? I think it just alerted the enemy. All right, where are you? Let me kill you. There you are. Lucky you, you only get one flame spout because I'm too lazy to change my left hand into another flames. Pretty close to a level up here. All right, so let's hold this again. It's not really doing anything, but it is draining my... Oh, there we go. Yeah, so it shows you, like, the way out. Although, of course, we don't want to go that way. We want to go further into Ember Shard Mine. And you guys have already heard my thoughts on clairvoyance. If you have to use clairvoyance in Skyrim, chances are you should probably not be playing this game. And that might offend some people, but it's just the case. This game is not really that difficult to find your way out of. It's not like Morrowind, where there's just so many options and so many doors, and you don't have waypoints, etc. Ring of Minor Sneaking, we will equip it. Why not? And I don't believe there's anything left in here, so let's move further. We have a door here, which is going to open with the Ember Shard Mine Key. And nothing else inside. So yeah, once we get to locations that we haven't been before, we'll take our time. Just for now, I'm going to be sort of sprinting and moving much more quicker than I normally would be. Okay, coin purse here. None of these guys are alerted, which is absolutely insane. Now they are. I spoke too soon. I agree. Bye-bye. Consider that game ended. What do you got? Okay, and let's see. We've got some iron ingots. A whole bunch of stuff. We're going to do what we did the last time and just activate all these tutorials, get them out of the way right now. We're already ahead of the last time we did this Let's Play because we actually kept our mage gear equipped. The last time we had like the Imperial stuff on the entire time and I thought we had the mage stuff, but we didn't. But this time we do. You cannot use this while in combat. Oh, that's unfortunate. We also have light armor forging. Guys, everybody take a guess. What do you think this book is going to increase in terms of skills? I'd say, I was going to say light armor. But it's actually smithing. I made myself look like a jackass. Cool. But we did get a level up. Wow, I can't believe that just happened to me. And I've already looked at that book too, the last time we were here. Okay, I believe we can hit this guy from down here, right? Yes. Burn! Alright, any more? No. Let's go ahead and level up, shall we? So, the last time I asked what is the best way to level up a mage, since I never play mage characters, and everyone was saying to, like, put 100 points into magic, because then you get efficient bonuses on the mage stuff, like, you know, the percent regeneration. So, I will do that, but I just want to make sure. So, if that's not correct, you know, leave comments, let me know, because I never play mages. But I think, yeah, the consensus is to put 100 points into magic. Or, 10 levels, right? So, yeah, 10 levels, which is 100 points. And then you'd never have to put any more points into magic again. I believe that's what you're supposed to do. But right now, our magic is totally fine, so we'll put it into health. And let's level up destruction. Cast novice level destruction spells for half magic. Cuh, that sounds pretty good to me. All right, so there should be nothing in this water over here, but we will take the alchemy ingredients. I believe we already searched that area. So let's go back up here. Just to let you guys know, just to give you like a little update, my stomach is rumbling like crazy. I'm very hungry, but I'm taking the time to record instead because it's more important. But I feel it. I freaking feel it. All right, what's in this room? A couple of chests, it looks like. Boom, boom. Or maybe just one chest. However, a whole bunch of jewels and gold. Every treasure hunter's dream. As I mentioned the last time, we are actually going to be taking jewels, which if you've watched my Skyrim's Hidden Treasures series, you know that that's not something I usually want to do. But since this is a new character, of course, it makes sense. However, if this was on a character that I had already pretty much completed everything, I would not be taking the gold, the jewels. Because you have to sell them. It's another step, whereas the gold goes straight into your pocket. Yeah, the jewels are worth way more, but the gold goes straight into your pocket. There's no other step. Amulet of Debella, plus 15 speechcraft. We'll equip that. And let's go ahead and finish off this location. I'm not sure if we took longer or shorter to complete this location. It feels like about the same, to be honest. Alright, he's got nothing left, which means we're gonna throw his body into the water. That was kind of violent the way that we did that, and take your bow as well. If you don't know anything about me, if you're new to the channel, welcome first of all, but second, I love throwing bodies off of ledges. It's pretty much my favorite thing that I can do in the Elder Scrolls and in Fallout. And it looks like we have reached the end of Ember Shard Mine. In some of Skyrim's, oh, well, we're not even going to read that because the loading is too fast. Alrighty, that is the first dungeon of the game, and consider yourself cleared. You know what? I just realized I didn't actually hear the clearing noise. Did we clear that place? Yeah, we did. Huh, maybe I just didn't realize it happened, but there should be a clearing noise when you kill, like, the boss of an area. Alright, let's take a look at our quest. Hadvar suggested that I head to the nearby town of Riverwood. His uncle is the blacksmith there and should be able to help me talk to Alvor in Riverwood. And that's the only lead that we have other than join the Imperial Legion, which I'm still not made up about. I'm not sure if we're going to be doing that or if we're going to join the Stormcloak. So we will head to Riverwood. I know what stamina low means. And Riverwood is right here. And look how beautiful it is. So, so beautiful. And there's a bunch of stuff we can do in Riverwood, it being the first town of the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, of course. What are you doing? But the first thing we'll do is observe this interaction.
Shorts, bones. What happened to you, boy? Are you in some
Uncle,
kind
please,
of trouble?
Keep your voice down. I'm fine, but we should go inside to talk.
What's going on? And who's this?
He's a friend. Saved my life, in fact. Come on, I'll explain everything, but we need to go inside.
Okay, come inside then. Sigrid will get you something to eat, and you can tell me all about it.
A dragon! I saw a dragon!
What? What is it now, Mother?
It was as big as the mountain and black as night. It flew right over the barrel!
Dragons now, is it? Please, Muck. If you keep on like this, everyone in town will think you're crazy. And I've got better things to do than listen to more of your fantasies.
You'll see. It was a dragon. It'll kill us all, and then you'll believe me.
Psst, Hilde. I believe you.
Be careful. All right.
Let's head over to Alvor and Sigrid's house. And again, if you side with Raelof, something different happens. You go to, like, the woodcutter's house rather than the blacksmith.
Sigrid, we have company.
Whoa.
Guess Alvor has the ability to teleport. Good for him.
Hadvar, we've been so worried about you. Come, you two must be hungry. Sit down and I'll get you something to eat.
Now then, boy, what's the big mystery? What are you doing here looking like you lost an argument with a cave bear?
I don't know where to stop. You know I was assigned to General Tullius' guard. We were stopped in Helgen when we were attacked by a dragon.
A dragon? That's ridiculous. You aren't drunk, are you, boy?
Husband, let him tell his story.
Not much more to tell. This dragon flew over and just wrecked the whole place. Mass confusion. I don't know if anyone else got out alive. I doubt I'd made it out myself if not for my friend here. I need to get back to Solitude and let them know what's happened. I thought you could help us out. Food, supplies, a place to stay.
Of course. Any friend of Hadvar's is a friend of mine. I'm glad to help however I can. Like I said, I'm glad to help in any way I can. But I need your help. We need your help.
Alright, so like I said, this part is so weird to me. You just take their stuff, you take whatever you want. So we don't really need any of this stuff. We will take the Iron Ingot, the Potions of Minor Healing, Ring of Minor Deft Hands, sure. And a Silver Ring. So some people were saying a good rule of thumb is to take items that are equal to, like, for every pound, it should be worth 10 gold, right? So this is 0.3, and it's valued at 30. So that is something that we should take. And I guess we'll do that, although that's not really the way that I've always done it.
The Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Balgruuf in Whiterun to send whatever soldiers he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Okay. How do I get to Whiterun from here?
Cross the river and then head north. You'll see it just past the falls. When you get to Whiterun, just keep going up. When you get to the top of the hill, you're at Dragon's Reach, the Jarl's Palace.
Alright, and that's all we pretty much need to know.
Hadvar, did you really see a dragon? What did it look like? Did it have big teeth?
Well, I'd better get back.
Alright, so before we leave this place, we're going to steal all of their stuff, just like last time. We'll steal that gold. We'll take all this gold as well. Don't mind me, family. Just have your dinner. I'm just going to be taking everything. Pretty much making you poor. I mean, you're already pretty much poor, right? Everyone in Skyrim's poor. At least like 90% of the population. But, yeah, this stuff's going to help me out a lot more than it's going to help you out. So don't mind me. Oh, I am making myself at home. Yeah, I'm just going to be taking all of your stuff. What do you got in this barrel? Cabbage? No, I'll let you keep your cabbage. How about the chest? Yes, that's what I like to see. Leather strips are actually really important with the Hearthstone. No, Hearthstone. No, what's it called? The Hearthfire DLC? I've been playing a lot of Hearthstone, if you can't tell. Okay, let's take that. And I think that's it. Ooh, what do you got here? Blacksmith's potion. Yeah, some of the stuff, you have to steal it, which doesn't make sense. You can just take other
stuff.
It's nice
to be back in a friendly
spot. But let's go ahead and go back into Riverwood. Now, there's two more things that we want to do, just like the last time we were here. The first thing that we want to do is find Sven or Falion, I believe his name is. I'm not sure where they're going to be. So I think the last time we just waited. Yeah, let's do that. So it's 6:49 p.m. 12 hours would be 6, 7, 8. Let's wait till 9 a.m. These guys are usually out here in the morning. I think I already mentioned this, but oh my god, it's so much better to be able to... No, actually, I mentioned this on stream, I think. But it's so much better to be able to wait whenever and not have to sit down like in Fallout 4. Again, I don't know why they did that. All right, where are you, Sven? Come on. Sven or Falion, I need to see you guys. Do you know where your boy is, Hild? I don't even know if I should pronounce the E in that, or if it's just Hild. Who do we have over here? Ooh. Yes, okay, that should be Snow. No,
I don't owe you money, do I?
Damn it! Where are these people? Let's wait a couple more hours and see if they show up. This isn't even really that important. I just want to close out all business in Riverwood. Alright, well, I guess let me just wait until I find them. Nope, that looks to be... Yes, okay, here we go. What's up?
Greetings, Brother Elf. Good to see a familiar face so far from home.
What's your problem with Sven, even though he didn't mention that at all?
He's a bard, so he says. Occasionally, he finds time to do his job here at the mill. Thinks his ballads and sonnets are going to convince Camilla Valerius to marry him. As if she would say yes. An intelligent, beautiful woman like her wouldn't fall for that nonsense. I hope.
You hope? You don't sound very sure.
I've been thinking. Maybe Camilla needs a little help seeing Sven for what he is. Could you give her this letter and say it's from Sven? I think I've matched that Nord's lack of cleverness perfectly.
Okay, so we have a little miscellaneous quest here. Deliver Faendal's letter to Camilla or tell Sven about Faendal's letter. Let's take a look at the letter. My dearest Camilla, I yearn to have you as my own, washing my linens and my fine blonde hair, to cook my dinner from my stove and tend to my house while I wander. Yours truly, Sven. It doesn't even rhyme. Is that a poem? Alright, let's go ahead and activate that. Okay. Tell Sven about Faendal's letter. Deliver Faendal's letter to Camilla. So if we tell Sven, he'll give us a... Actually, we've never done it like this. So let's do the optional objective. This is where Camilla is, so we want to actually go over here, which I believe is going to be the Sleeping Giant Inn, right? Indeed it is. Yeah, I've never done it this way. In fact, the last time we did this LP, it was the opposite.
Faendal thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling him.
So I think this is not going to lock us in with Sven, but Faendal wanted me to deliver this letter to Camilla and say it was from you.
What is this? The elf playing a treachery? Shocking. As if I would write this dribble. How about we play a bit of a turnabout with Faendal? Here, I had to use simple words, but this letter should convince Camilla it's from him.
Interesting. I don't think I've actually ever read this one. Sven's fake letter from Faendal. What do we got here? Dear Camilla, I know I have called upon you at your house many times, and while we may be growing close, I need you to put any desires you may have for me aside. I am a true-born son of Valenwood, and I could never be foul my bloodline by courting an Imperial. I hope we can remain true friends, provided you understand your people's place in the Aldmeri Dominion and respect me as such. Sincerely, Faendal. Jesus! Nice little racist letter there. That's always nice. So hopefully, like I said, that doesn't lock us with Sven, because we actually want Faendal, because there's a thing that you can do. We're not going to do it. I never do exploits.
I said.
But there is an exploit you can do with Faendal where you give all your money to him to train you at archery, you level up, and then you make him your follower, and you just take the money back from his inventory. So you can keep doing that. Again, I don't do exploits. Even in normal playthroughs when I'm not playing on YouTube, I don't do exploits or anything like that. It ruins the fun for me anyways. So yeah, we're not going to be doing that.
No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
We are done talking about this. Oh, a customer. Sorry you had to hear that.
Sounds like you may have a quest for me, but first we've got other business.
Maybe you could talk some sense into my pig-headed brother.
Okay. Sven wanted to trick you into believing this letter was from Faendal.
What are you talking about? What's in the letter? Oh my. He wanted me to think Faendal wrote this? Thank you for telling me the truth. Could you talk to Faendal as well? I'm sure he'll want to thank you for standing up for him.
Again, I'm really surprised and disappointed that there's no option to just get rid of both of them, because they're both terrible people and they want to manipulate Camilla. But oh well, let's talk to Lucan Valerius.
The Riverwood Trader is everything you need in a general store.
Okay, the first thing Adrenok would be interested in is, do you sell spells?
I think I have a few old spell books laying about. If you want more, you'll have to go to the College of Winterhold.
Okay, did something happen?
Yeah, we did have a bit of a break-in. We still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament. Solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw.
I could help you get the claw back.
You could? I've got some coin coming in from my last shipment. It's yours if you bring my claw back. Now, if you're going to get those thieves, you should head to Bleak Falls Barrow, northeast of town. Yes. So now you don't have to go, do you?
Oh, really? Well, I think your new helper here needs a guide.
No, by the eight, fine. But only to the edge of town.
I didn't need a guide last time, Camilla. I don't need a guide this time. But go ahead, go. You're gonna be waiting for like 10 hours because I'm not leaving. We got some other business.
The sooner you find the claw.
Yeah. What do you got for sale?
A bit of this and a bit of that.
Okay, let's get rid of all the excess stuff that we have. How about weapons? We won't sell the arrows just in case we switch to archery at some point. I don't expect that to happen, but hey, you never know. Okay, so the iron great swords, iron swords, war axes, war hammers. And I think we'll keep one bow just in case we need to use it for some reason. I'm not sure why we would, but just in case. Okay, boom, boom, boom. Yeah, we're gonna keep that stuff so that we can disenchant it. Boom, boom, and all that stuff. How much gold you got left, buddy? 500, not bad, not bad at all. We're not gonna use any stamina potions. We're just gonna sell them all. Not gonna sell any ingredients. Not gonna sell that. Let's see. We're gonna keep all the ores and ingots. And there we go. Now let's talk about those spell books you have, my friend. Okay, clairvoyance, frostbite, fury, lesser ward, oak flesh, and raised zombie. Just like the last time, we're not gonna buy any of these just because we're gonna find them eventually.
All right, then.
And they're not really, we're not gonna use them at all.
We have to go through town and across the bridge to get to Bleak Falls Barrow. You can see it from here, though. The mountain just over the buildings.
Is that it? That's your guide? Wow,
those
thanks.
Thieves must be mad hiding out there.
Okay, whatever. All right, let's go find Feind. I forget how they pronounced it. But Feindal, whatever his name is. We should be right over here. How's it going, buddy? Excuse me.
Tell me as soon as you've given Camilla the letter.
I don't think Camilla will be spending any more time with Sven.
I appreciate your help. Please, take this. Some gold I've saved up from working at the mill.
And we've been given 25 gold, which is a pretty shitty reward for all the running around we've been doing. So now we can have him as a follower, and we're not going to because Adrenok is a lone wolf, and I always play as a lone wolf anyways. But like I said, we can give him our money to train us at archery, and then we can have him follow us, and then we can just take that money back. But we're not going to be doing that. No, we are not. In fact, the fate that awaits Feindal is much worse than that. In fact, he's going to be, I don't want to spoil it, but let's just say it involves Boethia. And Boethia is not the most nicest of Daedric princes. Yeah. All right, let's go ahead and see what we've got. Visit the College of Winterhold, join the Imperial Legion, all things that we will do in time. That is our main quest, but we're going to put that on hold for now. Lucan Valerius in Riverwood has offered me a gold reward if I retrieve his antique golden claw, stolen by bandits camped in Bleak Falls Barrow. And we need to retrieve the golden claw. And like I mentioned the last time, I shudder at all of the people that are going to go straight to Whiterun instead of doing this quest first. You pretty much want to do this quest first because you kill two birds with one stone. As you will see later on. The last time we were roaming this mountain, my frame rate was just pausing every like 10 seconds, and it was crazy, and I was like, please don't show up in the final recording, in the final rendering of the video. And unfortunately it did. This time, however, everything is smooth as a baby's bottom. So that is wonderful. Let's go this way towards Bleak Falls Barrow. We're getting pretty close to the end of this episode. I think we're going to do pretty much the exact same thing that we did in episode 2 the last time around. We're going to clear out that tower up there, and then we will end the episode. So these guys are going to be nice, probably. They're going to welcome me with open arms. Just kidding, they're bandits. So they're going to burn alive. What else is new? Okay. Still got one more, but let's loot these guys real quick. Where'd you go? There you are. Boom, boom. All right. Okay, let's kill this guy before we do something with that body over there. and not what you're thinking. Get your minds out of the gutter, you sick sickos. Oh, wait, we didn't search this person just yet. Okay, there we go. And now... Oh, I don't think I did that well. Okay, let's try that again. Take two. I don't think we'll have the strength to throw them clear off the ledge, though. Come on! Over the ledge, let's go! Ah, so close. Alright. Okay, coin purse here. Let's see, should be some stairs leading upwards. I can't tell you guys how many times I have looted this entire tower. About 100, probably. 100 times. And at the top is going to be a chest. And I'll take the silver necklace. Thanks for watching this episode of Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys in the next one where we enter Bleak Falls Barrow. Bye-bye.